So you just booked your first hostel. How exciting. Hostels are budget accommodations that are usually in major cities that rent out beds instead of rooms. I've personally stayed in a room with one stranger, 150 strangers, and everywhere in between, though the average is about 6 to 10 beds in one room, with an option to stay in a mixed dorm or with just your gender. If you've never stayed in a hostel before, you might have a lot of questions before booking your first one. But I have stayed in 25 hostels and am here to share with you how amazing they have been for me because they allowed me to see 14 countries around Europe for very cheap. So without further ado, here are the top 10 things that you should know before staying in your first hostel. All right, so first, you're definitely going to need to bring your own lock, possibly multiple locks. I brought two with me, one for my lockers in the hostels and one for my bag that were TSA approved. But I also used those in my hostels for when the locks were a lot smaller on the lockers than I had anticipated, because you really never know what you're gonna get until you go there, so you wanna be prepared for anything. But I'd say my padlock did fit on about 99% of the lockers. Now, the lockers vary in size by hostel. Some places charge for their lockers. I really hate that, but there was this one in Switzerland that they wanted you to pay 16 francs for like 5 hours, and I was like, absolutely not going to happen. So that's why I also brought cable locks. I think mine are in the car, so here's a picture of them. But I would take these cables, I got two of them, and I would wrap them all around my camera bag because I'm traveling with expensive equipment. If you're not traveling with anything expensive, then you really don't need to bother with these. But if you are traveling with something that you don't want to get stolen, I wrapped them all up in my cable bags and I basically locked it to the bed where somebody would not be able to get it without taking the entire bed with them. And then I put my small TSA lock on my camera bag so nobody could get into it when I wasn't there. See, I'm from New York, so I just assume everybody's gonna steal everything, and I just, you know, wanna make sure everything's nice and locked up. Though in Switzerland, I never had a problem in Switzerland. As for the key, you definitely don't wanna lose that because it is the key to all your stuff. If you look at all my Europe vlogs, I'm wearing a key around my neck, and that was the key to my lock for my locker. I never lost it. Does it look tacky? Maybe. I probably should've got a nicer key, but you know, to each their own. All right, the second tip I have for you is to bring shower shoes. This might sound a little weird, but you're going to be showering in like a communal shower, like at the gym. You wouldn't want to have your bare feet on that type of shower because though it probably does get cleaned once a day, how many people are actually using that shower within those 24 hours? So I would definitely suggest bringing some type of flip-flop or shower shoe to have. All right, next we are going to talk about plugging in our electronics because that is very important in this day and age. You're probably wondering, well, where am I gonna plug that in at night? So after going to about 25 hostels, I'd say maybe only two or three of them did not have a plug at my bed. One of that would be that giant tent that I stayed in, and I think another one was just like a random older hostel that didn't have these like near each bed. But here's my best tip for this. One thing you definitely want to carry with you is a portable charger, a big one, like a big bank. I got a huge one at Walmart for $5 and it lasts you all day. And it definitely fills up my phone about twice. So whenever I did have a plug at my bed, I would charge up my phone and that portable charger. And if then I encountered a hostel that did not have a plug at the bed, I would just plug in my phone to that portable charger and keep that under my pillow. And you know, I just generally kept my phone under my pillow when I slept, and nobody ever tried to reach under and grab it from me. And if you are not from the country that you're visiting, make sure you have a plug adapter. Sometimes hostels will sell them, knowing that you're forgetful. Amazon has them for really cheap. All right, for tip number four, we are going to talk about the kitchens in hostels because they are great and they will save you so much money. They are usually stocked with plates, utensils, pots, pans for you to use. And please be respectful and clean up after, because the worst thing is going to cook in your hostel kitchen and somebody had just left a bunch of dishes that you would probably want to use. Definitely clean up after yourself. And most of these hostels also have like communal fridges. Tag your food and leave it in the fridge and you'll be able to eat it for a few days if you stay there, which is great because it saves you so much money when you don't have to go out to eat. Sometimes hostels will provide things like oil and like a few spices, but not all of them and not most of them. So prepare for that and probably bring your own. Or scope out the kitchen when you get there, see what they have, and then go food shopping. But the biggest thing about that is just be respectful to others using the kitchen so it can be a nice place for everyone to use. Now, another great thing about hostels is a lot of them have laundry services. They will either have machines that you will need to bring coins to use, or they have like a full-on laundry service where you bring them a bag of clothes, they do it, they fold it, and they give it back to you, usually for about $7 to $10. It's a really convenient thing to have, so definitely if you're looking for hostels to book on bookingourhostelworld.com, See if they have a washing machine, if that's something you're gonna need in the future. Okay, this is another random tip that usually isn't talked about much, but you're gonna get your key card for your hostel room. Don't leave it near your phone. Like, if you keep your phone and your wallet together, like I would always put everything in my money belt, so my wallet and my phone were touching, and so many times it just deactivated my hostel card, which can be really annoying if you're coming home at like 1 in the morning and you're trying to get into your room and it's just denied, 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 and you're probably annoying everybody who's sleeping in there by trying to get the door to open, and you gotta go back down to the front desk and they gotta renew your card. That happened to me about 4 times because I just kept putting my cell phone near my wallet. Just keep that in mind. Okay, this next tip is a big one because it's about hostel etiquette. There are just some rules that you should follow when you're staying in a hostel room because you're staying with a bunch of strangers. Some of the worst things that I've encountered would be being woken up at 4:30 a.m. to somebody packing up their very loud bag because they needed to go on their next train or to the airport or whatever. If you know you're leaving very early, pack up all your stuff the night before when nobody is sleeping, especially if you don't know how to be quiet. Same goes for if you're getting in late to your hostel room. Don't flip on the light switch and wake everybody up so you can find your stuff to shower. Plan ahead. If you know that you want to take a shower when you get home late, have everything already sitting in your locker the way that you need it to be. So you can just quietly walk in with your flashlight on your phone, don't turn on the light, grab your stuff, and just be quiet and respectful, how you would want to be treated, basically. Don't like hang all your clothes around the room, like stick to your space. So if you're a backpacker and doing a lot of travel by trains and planes and you can't really, you know, plan always when you're going to get to your hostel. If you get there super early, like 9 in the morning, most hostels will allow you to leave your baggage at the front desk. They'll usually have like a little room or something for you to lock your bag up, or they'll take it for you. Most hostels are really accommodating with that. So keep in mind, if you do arrive early to the city, go ahead and go drop your stuff off. Don't bother dragging it around for 6 hours. Okay, this next one is a give or take. I am a quite anxious person, and I know that all I really, really needed, anything can get stolen from me on that trip except for my passport. I can't lose my passport. I can't go anywhere without my passport. So that always needed to be on me, and my wallet. Those are 2 things that I really needed to survive. Anything else, all my clothes, makeup, even camera equipment, if it got stolen, I can afford to replace it. Or insurance, if you have insurance. But those 2 things I kept on me basically all the time, and I definitely slept with them on. And I would suggest that to you too, especially in places that maybe don't have lockers. If you have like a secure locker that you know nobody could get into, then you're fine to leave your passport in there. But I did stay in some hostels that like looked like you might be able to like reach your fingers into in between the bars. And like I said, I'm a little bit anxious and paranoid person, so I just wanted to make sure that I always had those things. Especially my Eurail pass. If I lost my Eurail pass, they're mobile now, but if I did lose it, that would be it for my trains for the entire trip. Like, I would have to either pay another $900 for that Eurail pass or pay out of pocket for each and every train, which would have been crazy expense. So I definitely suggest sleeping with those things on you under your clothes. Get a nice tight money belt from Amazon and then you won't have to worry about it. The last thing that we're gonna talk about today is how to meet strangers. The best part about hostels is that most of the time, people are there to make friends. They wanna be social. If you're staying in a room with 20 other people, it's kind of hard to not be a social person. I was able to go up and talk to basically anybody I wanted and like, hey, you wanna get some dinner? Like, I just flew in, I'm hungry. What are you doing? I see you're sitting alone. Most of the time people be like, yeah, I'm hungry, I'd love some dinner, or I'd love to go get a drink, or I'd love to go play cornhole. Like, it's so easy to walk up to people at hostels because of the type of environment that it is. And a lot of hostels also host like bar crawls, or just activities, day tours, a lot of things to bring the community together. So if you were worried about going to a hostel and being like, oh, how am I gonna make friends? There are so many ways to do that. And just scope out the hostel that you're in and see which way works best. Highly suggest the bar crawls though. Those are always so much fun and you meet so many people. All right, I hope those tips made you a little bit less anxious about staying at your first hostel because they are truly awesome to stay at. They really changed my life and my travel and let me go so much further than I would staying at $100 a night hotels. And they're also a great place to meet lifelong friends. All right, you guys, if I missed anything or if you have any more questions about anything hostel related, please drop me a comment below and I will do my best to answer it. Thanks for watching, happy travels, and I will catch y'all on the next one.